If you're a sports fan, make sure you go check out SportsCastr for all of your sports needs. Whether you're a football fan, basketball fan, or baseball fan, this app is the perfect way to get news for your team and is an app I personally use myself in case any of you guys want to check out my pregame, halftime, or postgame streams. I'll leave a link in the description below. What is up, Pats Nation? It's Paige's Global back here with another video, and in this one, we're going to be talking about how the Patriots have placed wide receiver Gunner Olszewski on season-ending injured reserve. Now, of course, this move comes as the Patriots had to make room for left tackle Isaiah Wynn. The Patriots are bringing him back from the injured reserve, and of course, they need to make room for him in order for him to be activated for the game against the Cowboys. So for those of you wondering who the Patriots were going to be releasing to make room for Wynn, you now have your answer. Now the good thing about this is the fact that the Patriots will still be able to have Gunner Olszewski for next season. They'll be able to have him for, you know, OTAs, minicamp, training camp, as long as, you know, they decide to keep him around, but he will be able to be in a Patriots uniform again this offseason. And I'm not sure how real it is, you know. I'm not sure how much of an injury he really was dealing with to actually be placed on the injury reserve. Now, I do know Gunner Olszewski has been dealing with some injuries the past couple of weeks. He wasn't active versus the game versus the Eagles. But from my understanding, the Patriots played it up a little bit in order to just place him on the injury reserve rather than just releasing him. Gunner has really done the bulk of his work on special teams. You know, kick returner, punt returner, hasn't done anything too crazy. Has had some nice runs, but nothing lethal. You know, you're not going to put Gunner Olszewski back there on a kick return or punt return and be like, okay, you know, he's going to get this out to the 50. He's going to put us in great field position. Oh, this could be returned for a touchdown. You know, he just hasn't provided that type of spark. Now, he has also provided depth to the Patriots receiver group, which, of course, they've actually had to utilize him because the Patriots have been banged up, okay? Let's keep in mind, there was a point Josh Gordon was injured, Julian Edelman, Philip Dorsett. They were really banged up at a certain point, and guys like Jacoby Myers and Gunner Olszewski were actually getting time in the Patriots starting offense and actually got some balls thrown their way. Gunner Olszewski, of course, really is the last receiver on the Patriots' depth chart. He's definitely not the first guy that they're going to go to, but again, serves as depth. If someone goes down, all right, you're going to plug Gunner Olszewski in. Now, this move really isn't going to affect the Patriots all that much, okay? It's really going to affect the fans more because there is so many fans of Pats Nation that are just so for Gunner Olszewski. So this is probably more of a disappointment to Pats Nation rather than it actually affects the team. Really, the only negative way that it's going to affect them is depth, okay? Believe it or not, he's 6'1". He doesn't look like it, but he is. And this is going to be one less receiver that the Patriots will be able to have when it comes to depth. But as for, you know, who's going to be returning balls, who's going to be returning kicks and punts, you know, are we in a bad position without Gunner Olszewski? And the real and probably obvious answer to this is no, okay? Last week when he wasn't playing versus the Eagles, we got a lot of Mohamed Sanu action. Now, we had some action from, of course, Brandon Bolden, which isn't surprising at all. Brandon Bolden isn't a bad return specialist. I actually would say that he's done more than Gunner Olszewski has, but, you know, he's not a Cordarrelle Patterson level type threat. But the Patriots will definitely be okay without Gunner because we've seen great sparks from wide receiver Mohamed Sanu. There was a point versus the Eagles that if he hadn't gotten tripped up by one Eagle, he easily would have been off. And what I like about that and having, you know, Sanu return it is the fact that he's a big receiver, he's faster than Gunner Olszewski, and he's a veteran in the NFL, okay? We're not going to have to be worried about putting some undrafted rookie back there and him potentially muffing the ball. Now, of course, there always is the chance that any guy could, but when you have a pretty sure-handed veteran like Sanu, that's something you really don't have to worry about. So truly, in my eyes, the Patriots are getting an upgrade when it comes to a return specialist. Now again, we have seen some positive things from Gunner Olszewski, but he's definitely a rookie, okay? It shows that he's a rookie out there on the field. He's made some mistakes. He's made some rookie mistakes at that. So hopefully he's able to get healthy. He's able to learn on his time off. And we'll be able to see Gunner Olszewski back in the offseason. And hopefully he's able to provide some type of bigger spark than he's been able to provide so far this season. Gunner is definitely a fan favorite, but he really does need to step it up in order to keep himself on the team, both as a return specialist and as a receiver. But that's going to be it for today's video. Gunner Olszewski is done for the rest of the season. Isaiah Wynn is back. If you haven't checked that video out, go check it out right now. Not one you're going to want to miss. But make sure you guys like this video and subscribe if you have not already. Make sure you guys share this video with everybody else so we can go to the Page's global family. And other than that, I will catch you guys in another video.